Good morning on this Thursday morning. I hope you have your candle and your Bible ready. Welcome to this time with God. Let's worship. O Lord, open our lips and we shall declare your praise. Would you sing with me? You'll find the words in the details section of the video. Eternal God, our beginning and our end, be our starting point and our haven, and accompany us in this day's journey. Use our hands to do the work of your creation, and use our lives to bring others the new life you give this world. In Jesus Christ, Redeemer of all. Amen. This morning's scripture is from 1 Peter, all the way toward the back of our New Testament. Chapter 2, verses 4 through 10. Come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. And like living stones, let yourself be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, "See, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you, then, who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the word, as they were destined to do. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy." Our second hymn this morning should also be familiar. So let's sing.
Thank you.
Let us pray once more. Loving God, as the rising sun chases away the night, so you have scattered the power of death in the rising of Jesus Christ, and you bring us all blessings in him. Especially we thank you for the community of faith in our church, those with whom we work, the diversity of your children, the signs we see of your love at work in the world, and we thank you for those who work for reconciliation. Mighty God, with the dawn of your love, you reveal your victory over all that would destroy or harm, and you brighten the lives of all who need you. Especially we pray for our family, our friends, our church family. We pray for families suffering separation. We pray for people who are different from us. We pray for those isolated by sickness or grief. We pray for the victims of violence or warfare. And we pray, especially now in this moment of silence, for the concerns that are heavy on our hearts today. God, would you hear your children praying, and would you give us ears to hear you? God, hear our prayer. And now hear us as we pray together the prayer that your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. As we close this time of worship and prepare to go into the world today, I send you with this blessing. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with you today. Amen.